Namaste friends, today we are going to see a very short, this is a very short video, and this video is all about us, all about the skills. So in every plant you will find a skill, many skills. There are some plants where the entire plant is made out of connecting different skills together. So today we are going to see in 5 minutes how a skid is designed, what are the important key points which are to be considered while designing a skid, which are very important, okay, from the design point of view. So this is a skid. Skid is in fact a kind of a small plant which is having an independent process and input and output together. So this is a skid I have shown here for representation purpose. So we will see, if I want to design a skid, first and foremost important is I need to have some process. So for that process, it will have input connection and output connection. So we will, once this skid is designed, it is placed in the plant, then there are certain lines which are connected to the input, and there will be a process inside the skid, and after the processing, whatever output or the finished product for that skid is then transferred via some output connections to the plant. So this is basically a skid. So if we want to design a skid, first important point is we should have a process. First important point is that we should have need is process. Second, whatever space that is required for this process, it will involve receivers, maybe some pumps, and then some reflex drum. So many things may be involved in the process. So whatever space which is required from the maintenance point of view, operation point of view, that has to be estimated, including all the piping, cable trays, etc. So based on that estimation, we will come to certain dimensions X, Y and Z. This is the requirement, space requirement for the given skid which is having a process inside it, given process inside it. So that is one thing. This depends on the process and the size of equipments inside the skid. Second point is the time location. So this skid is going to place inside a plant. In that plant, we will be having the input and output connections. So those input and output connections are called as time connections. So whichever lines that are going to connect to the input, they are the input times, and the lines which will be connected to the output, they are the output times. So based on the plant, based on the information that is available from the site visit or whatever the other detail engineering companies working out the location of this time point, input and output, that has to be provided to the skid designer. Then third, this is very important part, that is the wherever we have the time location points for the pipe. So always if there is some considerable temperature in those lines, then there will be definitely some expansion at these tiny locations. So it is always advisable that this expansion should not be transferred to the line which is outside the battery limit of this skid. So for that, we can either provide an anchor at the time point location, or second option available is providing the expansion bell also. So this is the third point which is to be taken into consideration for design. The fourth point, which is the internal process, of course the internal process, we have to design the all the layout, general arrangement for the entire process. It will include receiver, pumps, filter, whatever it may be, which is there in the PNID. And second important thing is that there may be two types. One is that the entire skid is doesn't require whatever operation, whatever operational walls and pressure gauge will be there, it will be near the tying locations. So you need not have to enter inside the skid space. But in some cases where the internal of the skid, whatever equipments are installed, they may require maintenance and you have to enter. So in that case, some accessway is also provided for operation also and for maintenance also. So in that case, we have to estimate from where the accessway should be provided, considering the safety and the operability. So these are the four important points which a skid designer should always consider. So thanks for watching this video. Do like and share this video. This is your channel, so
it's your duty to make it famous. Thank you for watching.